Hello, my name's Phil Frost from Mercy, and I'm here to tell you about the forthcoming Charities conferences. We've got three conferences coming up in the next few months. There's one in London, one in the East Midlands, and there's one also in Stirling. Now, there's slight differences in the content within the conferences. And the reason for that really is that the conference in Scotland will address particular issues from the rules and regulations, as that is slightly different to England and Wales. But broadly speaking, we will be covering similar things. We've run these conferences for a number of years in sort of February March time, which is hopefully an opportune time for those of you sort of dealing with the preparation, audit, independent examination of charities, or indeed looking from things from a tax perspective. Many of them having December and March year ends. And what we'll cover on the conferences are sort of matters which relate to tax, sort of legal, accounting, regulatory matters, and I've already said the slight differences between Scotland and England and Wales, and each of the speakers will reflect that. As for my session, I'll be covering the changes which are being proposed and maybe hopefully finalised over the next few months in terms of how the charity SORP will change under the umbrella of the new UK GAAP, IFRS 102, changing in 2015 with comparatives in 2014 changing. So I'll be exploring the changes that come as a result of the charities SORP. Partly changing because of IFRS 102, but also because the sort of the SORP committee have been doing their review, and there'll be one or two other things that will come through on that. The draft is out at the moment. The draft was out. The consultation period has ended, and we're told to expect the final version in the spring of this year. But in addition to looking at accounting matters, there will be a couple of sessions on taxation, one dealing with VAT matters, one dealing with direct tax matters, and specifically on direct tax, some issues to do with employment and tax relief on giving. As far as VAT is concerned, so the perennial issues in terms of what's within the scope of VAT for charities and what's not. As I say, we'll deal with regulatory matters as well, whether they be governance matters, whether they be legislation matters. In addition to that, we've got sort of three other sort of sessions within the conference. One will be on charitably incorporated organisations. They've been possible for just over a year now in England and Wales, a little bit longer in Scotland. So I'll be reflecting on the issues for those that have already registered as CIOs or COs in Scotland, and also whether existing charities should look to change, whether they be an unincorporated charity or a charitable company. We're also going to have a session on sort of managing the risk of fraud. If the statistics are to be believed, fraud within charities is on the increase. And seemingly, some statistics indicate that over £1 billion is lost to fraud from a charitable perspective, whether that's income never being received by the charity or perhaps maybe frauds within the charity. So there's sort of the main presentations, but one final one which I'd like to just refer you to. There will be one session which was somebody from a charity will come along talk to us. And we found that very useful, and delegates have found that very useful in the last few years, to get an insight into what charities themselves are looking for from their accountants, from their auditors, from their advisors. So useful to look at it from that perspective. Overall, these conferences are focused on sort of the practicalities, the pragmatic issues, matters which will hopefully be of use to you and the charities and the size of charities that you're having to deal with. So as I said, they're looming in towards the end of February and into March in London, in the East Midlands, and also in Stirling. So I hope to see you on one of them. Thank you.